the church, feeling water on your brow. It's healing, it hurts at first, a sharpish pain that returns as a thought, that the needle in your skin won't bring you closer to God. And I watch as your hand turns full circle.
This is our first Nissan Leaf video.
Yeah, we've had a Leaf now for about 18 months. It's done 16,000 miles. We thought of doing a video for a long time, and we toyed with the idea and just never really got around to it. But we're just on our way to Scotland. We live in South Leicestershire, so quite a long way. Probably going to do about a 1,000 miles, maybe 1,200 miles round trip. We're not really into planning and things like that. We just wing it, don't we?
We're winging it.
Yeah. So we'll just get in the car. We'll drive. Have a quick look on the map and see what services have got a charger that's ready. And we'll just pull in there and charge. And so far, we've never run out. We've come close a few times, haven't we?
We have.
We had an incident last week where
took a wrong turn.
Yeah. And we nearly ran out, but so far it's been great. And this is our main car, actually. We don't have another car. We've got a works van, but we use this for everything and go everywhere in it. So
it gets used every day for work.
It does.
My work.
So we'll do a couple of videos, show you the mileage and the charging at the various charge points that we go to, and just see how it goes. We apologise now if it's not a great video, but
We'll do our best,
yeah.
So half our stop at Knutsford and all charged. We've just bought a selfie stick, which is currently being used as we speak, and bought a bottle of water and some chewing gum. And now we're on our way up to Kendal, which is about 81 miles, and that will hopefully be our next stop.
Just, we've done about 70 miles. Oh,
low battery charge. Press 1 to check. Perfect timing.
Yeah, we've done about 70 miles, and we've got about another, I say, 14 to go. So I think we're pushing it a little bit, but we should be all right. Well, we'll see. That's us at Kendal now. To be honest, we did leave it a little bit close to the bone, I think. There was a services about probably a 10 miles back down the road, and we thought, nah, we'll wing it, we'll just leave that. And we've ended up coming up to the service at a Days Inn by some lakes, so but it certainly emptied the battery. So anyway, we're here now. We'll get it plugged in and get on our way. So we're just sat at Kendal now, just charging the car up to 90%. And I've got to say, what is amazing is that whilst we're charging it, we can have the heater going and the heater seats on, because it's 8 degrees outside and it's quite cold, I've got to say. So we're sitting in here keeping nice and warm. 86%, so only about 4% to go. And then we're going to fire off over to Ambleside, which is about 21 miles according to the sat nav. So and then we've got a B&B booked, and we're going to stay there for the night, aren't we?
We are. But in the meantime, we're nice and toasty.
Yeah, we are nice and toasty.
Yeah.
So.
So this is our first stop on the journey. We're in the Lake District. The Leaf got us here last night. We had a night in the B&B. It's very nice, wasn't it? It was comfortable.
It was very nice.
And then we've just been up Luffrigg, just run up Luffrigg, about 6 miles. Luffrigg's just over there. Can you see it? Just there. That's a bit of it anyway. So yeah, we've just run up there, and I think we're going to go and get a cup of tea now and a bit of chocolate. What do you reckon?
And we're going to charge the car because we went into a hotel that's got a charging point, and they said, yeah, if you come and have a drink in the bar, you can charge it up. So that's
for free.
What we're going to do. So we'll get a little video of that as well.
See you soon. Later.
So we've just got to Carlisle Services, plugged in. Gonna go and have a quick cup of tea and a quick loo break, and then we'll crack on. We're doing quite well, actually. I think we've efficiency wise, I think we're probably averaging about 80 miles to a charge, so which isn't bad considering it's mostly motorways, and a lot of that was through the national park, which is quite hilly. So yeah, doing really well.
Okay, I'll let you do the chops in.
So we've just charged at Carlisle. Is it Carlisle? It was Carlisle, wasn't it? Just been to.
Yes. Yeah.
Good.
Okay. So just recharged. We've got 95 miles. Bizarrely, that's dropped to 87, but I've popped cruise control on it anyway. So we're gonna head up to Glasgow, I think, and then across to Perth, and then probably up towards Aberdeen and sort of the east coast of Scotland. And ideally, we want to get up as far as we want to go to Strathy. So a nice B&B in Strathy that I've stayed in before, which would be nice. But that's good. I think that's probably a good 300 miles away from where we are still. So, but there's charging points all the way up. We've got our electricity card, which we use, and then we've got this one as well, which is charge car. We haven't used that one yet, but I dare say we're going to, because I think Ecotricity, although they've got a charge point at John O'Groats, I think their most northern one apart from that is Perth. Yeah. So
this one, we paid what, £20 for?
Yeah, we paid £20 for it, for the card, and then I think we registered our debit card against that. And then some of the charging points you use, you get charged for, not very much, I think 15p a kilowatt hour, just really what you'll pay for a kilowatt hour at home, but a lot of them are free. But they tend to be a little bit more spuriously placed. The Ecotricity ones all tend to be on the motorways in quite easily accessible places. The charger car ones,
a bit more random.
Yeah, a little bit more random, so, but we'll see, and I'm sure we'll make a video of it.
We'll let you know.
Yeah, we'll let you know. So.
Through the chart, oh no, only way I can be is to stay by the sea and then the shattering and over.
So we're at Abington Services now. We've come up from Carlisle, done about 70 miles on this charge, which wasn't particularly economical, was it? But we have done about 70 miles per hour all the way up the motorway, to be fair, haven't we? So
we have.
And it's been a bit hilly. And so we've just charged up, we've got 91%, 83 miles, and we're going to head up towards Perthshire, probably through Stirling, I think, and see if we can stop and charge there, but we might see if we can go to the next one. So we will see, and we will keep you posted.
It makes 50 miles, isn't it? I mean,
50 miles, it's not far. So we'll probably end up going up to the next one.
Is that to Edinburgh?
No, that was to Stirling, and then up to Perth. So we might end up stopping in Perth next.
All for free. Hopefully we'll have one of them soon. Not a charger, the card to plug into the charger. So that's us now at Kinross Services. I think we just got about 75 miles out of that charge, and we still had 15 to go. So that was with Kate driving. Clearly a much better driver than me. So just going to charge up here for half an hour, and then it's the changeover to charge your car, which I've got to say isn't filling me with love. It makes me a little bit nervous, but watching other videos and vloggers and electric car drivers, they seem to get on with it okay. So hopefully, fingers crossed, we shouldn't have any problems, and then northern tip of Scotland should be within our reach. So we will see. Anyway, we'll leave it to charge.
So we just stopped at Kinross, which is somewhere in Scotland, and they're charged to 91%. So we've got 81 miles, and we've just met a guy who, a Scottish man, and he had a Nissan Leaf as well, and he's assured us that the electric charging system through the Cairngorms actually works. So we're trusting him, because that's where we're going now.
We're going to be in trouble. He said it's very good, and he's shown us how to update our maps as well. So we've updated our maps, haven't we? So, and he's added a few new charging stations, which is quite useful. But Kate's driving because she gets a better range than I do. Cairngorm, it's Riachan Road, I think he said it was called.
Is that where we're going?
Riachan Road. Was it Pitlochy?
That's only saying, yeah.
And it's only 43 miles actually on the map. It looks vast.
It looks a lot further.
It does look a long way. The only thing that you can't see, of course, is the undulating ground, which sometimes that can take a few miles off you. So, but I think we'll be all right. We've got 90%, 80 miles, so we should be fine. So we're at Riachan Road in Pitlochry, I think, if that's how you pronounce it. No offence to anybody if I got it wrong, but I'm sure I'll be corrected. And we've just used an eVolt charger with Charge Your Car, and it was very fast, to be fair. I mean, probably 20 minutes and it's got us to 92%. So what we're heading up towards Inverness now. What would be amazing is actually if we just had a slightly bigger battery. If the new battery with the 155 mile range that's coming out, I'll take that with a pinch of salt as well, but probably 120, 130, that would do us. That would take us straight to Inverness, and of course the charging time would be down as well, because the battery capacity is higher. So, but we're doing all right.
Yeah,
we've got 82 miles on it, 92%, and about, I think, 68 miles to go, I think.
Right?
But it's a bit like this, so
we'll see.
I think we'll be all right, though.
Yeah.
So this is us at Avonmore. I've got to say, it wasn't the easiest charger to find. We had to do a bit of resetting, didn't we?
The postcode was completely wrong.
Yeah, the postcode was completely wrong. But this charger actually is in a car park next to the police station. That's probably easier for you to find next time. We're going to go and have a quick wee, and that's it. Then we're on our way again. So, nearly done. We've been here probably about 35 minutes. I don't think this one's quite as quick as the other one at, where was it?
Something beginning with P.
The last one we went to. And but that said, it's done the job, so it's just been a little bit longer. We're doing well. I mean, we're probably going to stop at Inverness and just have a quick 10 minutes, and that'll get us up to Thurso, I think. But we're going to stay at a hotel somewhere on the coast. We don't know where yet. We haven't arranged anything. Kate's going to do that now while I drive. But so far, 465 miles, and that hasn't cost us a penny. So, all good. So we've established that the lighting in the Leaf isn't amazing. So we've had to use Kate's phone to put a bit of light on our faces, which could be horrific for anybody watching, to be honest. we're in Inverness, so we've done 500 miles. We didn't really need to charge it, but we're charging it anyway. We're at another eVolt charger, using the charger car network, and I've got to say, it's fast again, it's really quick.
Mm.
I mean, it's put 8 kilowatt hours in probably the best part of about 10 minutes, which I think is pretty good. And the battery wasn't by any means empty. I mean, it's at 90% now, and 91 miles. So, and we've got a Premier Inn booked that we're going to head over to now. It's only 1.4 miles away, so we're going to stay there the night, and then in the morning we're going to head up to Thurso, where we're booked into a B&B in Strathy. So it's going well. Anyway.
Good night.
Yeah, let's go to bed. So we've just left the Premier Inn at Inverness. And we've got 90%, because we did a little charge last night for about 10 minutes just to top it back on. And 94 miles, we've got 66 to go, so no problems there. And then that'll be our last charge, I think, before we get to John O'Groats or Strathy. So everything's looking all right. We'll update you at the next charging station.
I can remember the good old days, where you and me used to hide away, where the stars were shining or the sun was blinding our eyes. Yeah, you filled up my glass with promises that could...
So we're at Helmsdale now. We've got 92.4% and 90 miles on the range. We've got about 55 miles to go to John O'Groats. So we're going to head up there and make use of Ecotricity's most northern charge point. And then we're going to nip across to Strathy. I think while we're up here, we're going to go to Orkney as well, aren't we?
I think so.
Going to get the... scrubs the ferry and go over to Orkney, because there's plenty of charge points on Orkney as well. So we're going to do that.
But
that's good. We've run 570 miles. It's all been free thanks to Ecotricity and Charge Your Car.
Arrived in John O'Groats, and we've done 56 miles since Helmsdale. And we've still got 31 miles left, so considering we've been going up and down like an
big
up
hills.
And down thing, then we've done really well. The Leaf's been amazing. Mm. And we've made it to the furthest point in the in Scotland, in the UK, all the way from Leicestershire. We've done 620 something miles.
Yeah, which I've got to say, when you think about the deviation for going to charging points, it's 600 miles anyway to do it in a car.
Yeah.
So I think that says that the charging points are well placed, you know, they're well thought out. Even the ones with Charge Your Car
random places.
Yeah, when I looked at them and said they're a bit spurious, to be honest, the one at Helmsdale, it was probably about 40 metres off the main road, down a little street in a car park, so it wasn't that bad at all, really.
No.
It's just we get used to Ecotricity, which are on the motorway services, and I suppose Charge Your Car, I've got to do that because they haven't got the motorways. So we're currently sat in front of the charger, which we're going to take a picture of in a minute, and then we're going to go and take a picture at the John O'Groats sign, aren't we?
Yeah.
And then we're going to just head over to Strathy, and that's it, we're done.
We're done.
We're going to go for a run, in fact. That's
done
what we're
going to do. Done for a few days. Driving. Done with driving.
Mm.
Yeah.
But I will say these words. I remember the first time, the first of many lies. Sweep it into the
Okay, lovely, thank you. Wow.
Everyone else has a little bit of like coffee.
Hello. So we've been driving around Orkney for a lot of the day. Managed to do, we're on 69 miles at the moment. And we're just headed back to the rapid charger at Stromness. We're going to charge there just before we get the ferry. Because we've had a little bit of trouble with the chargers back on the mainland. All the car chargers are either not connected or they don't seem to work. We're going to get a charge at Stromness. We're going to go back across to Strathy, stay the night, and then we're going to leave in the morning and start our journey back down. I think we're on about 800 miles. Probably be 800 miles now, isn't it? Yeah. So, in fact, I'm not sure if it was on 1600 when we left, and it's on 936 now. So, but we'll work it out and we'll get some figures and look at how many times we charge. See what it's like. So if anyone is watching and you know they're thinking about getting a Leaf, then they can look and maybe make a decision on whether it's right for them or just to show people that you can do a journey in it. We met up with a local guy.
Very low battery charge. Search for nearest charging station.
We met up with a local guy who he runs ecocars.net, a guy called John Porterfield, and he's got a little bit of an empire going up here by all accounts, isn't he? He's selling Leafs to everybody. I've seen more Leafs on Orkney than anywhere else in the country, so he's doing quite well. So we're unfortunately just leaving Patsy's B&B in Strathy. We have had a little bit of trouble with the local chargers, chargers. A lot of them seem to be on the app, they seem to be online, but actually when you get there, they're not working. It was okay over in Orkney, but here it's not been the case. But amazingly, Patsy said, "Oh, I think there's a guy around the corner with an electric car." And her neighbour, which nearly 3 miles away. We went round and he had an Ampera. And he said, "Yeah, plug it in." So we plugged it in there for a few hours and that got us 100%. So we're going to have a little bit of a jolly on the way back. We're going down to the local beach and then we're going to head down to Helmsdale, which I think actually is only about 45 miles, so we've got no worries there. But currently, I think I'm not sure what the mileage is, but we'll work it out. We've gone a long way, but we've got 86 miles on the range now and 96%, so all good.
So we left Strathy with about 90 miles, I think, on the Leaf, and we've just arrived in Helmsdale, about done about 43 miles, and we've still got 47 left.
Something that I did want to talk about was we had a problem with a rapid charger at John O'Groats, which I mentioned in a previous video. Now the or earlier on in the journey, what happened was we fast charged it, and it charged to 86% and then stopped, and we had about a 40-mile journey to go to the 40-mile journey to go to the B&B, and because the other chargers weren't working, we could only use that one, so it limited what we could do really. But so what we did was we plugged the fast charger back in, it charged for about 2 minutes and then stopped charging, and the battery monitor went to 100%. And when we started driving, we realised that it wasn't at 100% because the range it was giving us was 72 miles on a full charge, and we've never seen it that low. It's even in the winter, we still see 85, 86. Ultimately, the brake regen was working, so clearly we knew the battery wasn't 100% charged. Now, we kept using it and kept using it, and we weren't getting the range. This was on Orkney. We weren't getting the range that we had been. We found a local guy, bizarrely, about 2 miles down the road, which I previously mentioned, and we plugged it into his charger. And at 75%, it said it needed 4 hours to charge. Now, that's only a 13-amp 3-pin, and that's really, at 13 amps, is 4 hours is 50%. So that told me that the reading of the battery percentage was much higher than what's actually in the battery. So we left it on charge, and it fully charged, and that seemed to repair it. When we came back to it, the range had gone right back up to 92 miles, and it's been fine since. So I was wondering if something happened to the battery monitoring system where it needed to balance the cells, and because we've been fast charging, that maybe that had created the problem. But I don't know if anyone else has had that problem, but be interested to know. So
we just finished charging on the eVolt at Helmsdale, and we've got 93% and 93 miles, so the Leaf is clearly feeling better. And we're now heading to Inverness, which is 68 miles, and there's another rapid charger, an eVolt one, I think, isn't it?
There is.
In Inverness, so that's where we're heading to now. So we've arrived at the eVolt in Inverness, the Cathedral car park charger. We left with 93% and 93 miles, and we've done 68 miles to get here to Inverness, and as you can see, we've now got 11% and 12 miles. So, but it's not done badly. We've done a pretty much constant 60 miles an hour all the way.
Hello. We have just charged up at a rapid charger in Inverness, but we've got 82% and 82 miles, and I think we've only got 28 miles to go. We didn't really need to charge it that much, but we stood chops in. And we're on our way to Abermore, so... that was a 28-mile journey from Inverness to Abermore. To be honest, we bezzed it. We did 70 all the way here. It took about 25 minutes. So we're just charging up. 45% in there. This charger was quite quick the other day when we used it. I've got to say, when we turned up, we almost had a heart attack on the way up to the our destination, because it was all lit up red, and somebody had quite simply pressed the emergency stop button. But as you're driving into the car park and you see that, it doesn't fill you with love, I've got to say. Certainly didn't make us feel amazing. But it's charging away now, so we were going to get something to eat, but I think we might charge here. Oh, there's a Subway. We're going to have a wander around, get something to eat. We're going to probably let this charge to... Well, we'll just leave it till it stops, because the next location, I think, is about 75 miles. Hello. Just finished charging at the eVolt in Avonmore. Well, it switched off. We went and got some fish and chips. It switched off at 94%. I've just put the next location in. I thought it was much further than that. That's... Pit Lockery, only 55 miles, so we might miss that one.
and there's one about 84 miles which is to Perth, so we'll see how we go with the range, and then we'll make our decision sort of on the way. That said, it's getting dark, it's getting cold, so the heat is going to be on, so that's probably going to shorten our range somewhat, so we'll see. Hello.
Hello.
So we're at Riachan Road.
Pitlochry.
We got here with 21% at about 15 miles. So,
We've made pretty good time, actually.
We're doing quite well. However, you will notice it is dark. But we invested in a new LED light, which it was from Aldi, and it was about £3.
For two,
with batteries. So, we're on it. This charging, and then the next stop, I think, is going to be...
Kinross.
Are we going to stop there? Because that's not that far, is it?
Is it not?
No, I think Kinross is about 40 miles. I think we could probably get down to Abington.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Probably Abington?
Abington,
yeah. I think that's where we're going. So, anyway.
That's ecotricity again, isn't it?
It is back on ecotricity. So, but to be fair, charge your car have been amazing, apart from the few up on the very northern tip of Scotland, which nearly had us scuppered, but... So we've just got to Kinross Services, 35% on the, that's Kate just plugging it in, 35% on the battery, 31 miles I think, we didn't hang around this time either, and we're going to take it from here. I think we're going to go down to DC, she doesn't do this very often, we're going to take it down to, Abington, and then down to Carlisle, and then I think we're stopping somewhere in Carlisle because we're gonna have a couple of days in the Lake District again on the way home.
The 30 minutes charging on the ecotricity charger has got us to 98%, and so we're just gonna leave here now, and we're gonna head down to Abington and charge up there, and then on to Carlisle, I think so,
yeah,
for somewhere to stay.
Abington is 70 miles. So we've got 98%. It's done that quickly, hasn't it?
Really quick.
Bizarrely, I'm wondering if it's because the battery's quite warm. It's probably two bars under the red. But we've seen it up there before anyway on the way up. So we're just heating the car up on the charge points electricity, aren't we?
Yes, we are.
That's it. Let's get going. So we just had an interesting experience. Everything was going really well. Kate was driving and everything was spot on. We got the heater on, the heated seats, and we had a quick look at the miles, and we had probably about 8 more than we needed to get where we were going. And then we got confronted by a hill that seemed to go on for about 8 miles, and the range just disappeared and it dropped off. This is at Abington, by the way. Now, currently, I'll turn the camera around in a second to show you. Currently, we've got nothing on the screen, nothing on the battery, and we got the turtle, which we've been waiting to get. And it reduced the power, and it still managed about another four miles. And then when we got to the top of the slip road, it just died, everything went. But fortunately, as you come into Abington Services, it's all downhill, so we managed to roll. About 200 metres.
It was longer than that.
Maybe 250 metres.
Round a roundabout.
Round the roundabout, all the way through the services and up to the charger, which we're in front of at the moment. A little bit of...
Ski whiff angle,
yeah. I'll show you now if I just take it out the holder. Okay, if you just look there, you can see we've got nothing and nothing.
And our position.
And our position of parking is not amazing. living with a Leaf.
Winging it with the Leaf.
That's us then, fully charged, 95% in about 35 minutes in the quick cup of tea. We're just heading down to Carlisle now, which is 54 miles from where we are. So we shouldn't have any problems with that. We're on 350 miles for the day. So by the time we get there, it's going to be 400. So and that's going to be us wrapping it up for the night. Into bed, and a nice night's sleep, and a couple of days in the Lake District. So we'll keep it updated anyway.
Okay, very quick video. We've come down to Carlisle. We've got here, we're bang on 400 miles. We've got 26 to go, 28 on the battery. Battery's cooled down a bit actually, it dropped down 2 bars on the journey. Sorry, the lighting's not very good. Yeah, it's been a good day. Good day driving, and the Leaf's done a good job, to be fair. So yeah, it's another 400 miles for free. I'll just give you a quick once over the dash there. And then fortunately there's a charge point about 2 miles up the road, so we're going to hitch onto that tomorrow, get charged up, and that's going to take us just into Lake District. We're at a Premier Inn now, so we're going to get our heads down.
Morning. So we've had a night's sleep in Carlisle Premier Inn. We needed it. It was a long drive yesterday. We were shattered. So we've probably been up about an hour, something like that.
Yeah.
So we've just come up to the nearest charging point, which is about a mile and a half up from where we were staying, just outside of Costa, which is it? I don't know what the service station is called.
Todd Hills Services. Yeah.
So we're going to charge up here, and then we're going to head down to a place just south of Windermere, on the bottom of Windermere Lake, and we're going to stay there for a few days. This morning about 10 o'clock, and then we've stopped at Lancaster just to charge up, and I think the next stop will be Knutsford. We've got 82% on the battery, about 72 miles on the gasometer, and then so, and we've got 50 miles to go to the next station, charging station. So yeah, it's been an amazing time. We had a really good couple of days, didn't we, in there. Stayed in the yurt, went mountain biking yesterday in Grisdale Forest, and I think we're ready for home. So we'll see you at Knutsford. So we've just done 60 miles from Lancaster, and we're now at Knutsford. We got here still with 25 miles on the battery, so I think we've done pretty well, but I think it's just because it's flatter. Now we've been going up and down hills for the last week, and now we're on pretty much flat ground, so it's doing really well. So we're just charging, and we're now on 75% with 72 miles. So we're going to head down the M6 to, where's the next one?
I think we can get home, can't we?
Oh yeah, we might be able to get home.
Yeah.
So, and then we'll just plug it in when we get home and use the solar panels to charge the car. Yeah.
That's what we'll do.
So we'll see you at home.
Hello. We're just at Norton Gaines Services. We stopped to get a jacket potato because we didn't get any breakfast. Here she comes with the jacket potato now. Hello.
Hello.
Thank you very much.
Well.
That, in the time, you've got a jacket potato charged at 85%.
The M6 is apparently really badly congested, so everybody's come down here. It's rammed. It took me about 20 minutes to get to the loos.
What do you mean? Northbound or southbound?
Don't know.
Yeah, that junction that you said?
Yeah.
Okay.
There's one with pulled pork and one with tuna, so you can choose which one you want.
I'll have tuna, please. That's alright. Yeah. Is that my salad? So anyway, back to what we were saying. Norton Cane Services, just stopped for some food. In the time it's taken Kate to go and get two jack of potatoes, which admittedly there was a queue, we've managed to charge to 85% now, 86 miles. We did stop with 34%, but we're skinflints, and the more we charge here, the less we have to charge at home. We've currently covered 1,550 miles, I'd say roughly, and it's all been on either Ecotricity or Charge Car Chargers, and that was from Leicester, from Hinckley in Leicestershire to Strathy on the northern tip of Scotland, John O'Groats, and we went over to Orkney as well. The car's been absolutely fantastic. We've had no issues with it at all, and of course it's all been free. So it's certainly worth considering if you were looking at getting a Leaf. There's a lot of interest in the car as well. Every time you plug in, there tends to be people just wandering over, having a quick look. Mm. They want to know what's going on. They want to know what it's about. And I think with the recent events with Volkswagen Audi Group and their underhand tactics to their emission tests, I think it's probably going to do somebody else just... having a little nose, it's going to do the electric car world and plug-in hybrids a favour. I've never been a fan of diesel anyway. Diesel, I think diesels are dirty old cars. I'm much more a petrol fan. Isn't that nice?
It is really nice.
So I think we've got about probably 35, 40 miles to go till we get home. Mm-hmm. And then he'll be back on the drive. It needs a wash. It is covered. It's dirty. And then we'll plug it in, and we're going to get a shower because we've been camping for 2 days.